Hey guys, Jai Hind. Guys, today's video is going to be very very beneficial for all of you. Why? Because in this video we will discuss about a very wonderful topic. Then today's topic is time management. Guys, in this video we will discuss about time management because as we can see, so many people want to manage their time. But question is this, how to manage our time? Nobody wants to waste his time. Everybody wants to utilize his time. But question is this, how can we utilize our time? Then guys, in this video, I will tell you three techniques from which you can manage your time. Then watch the video till the end because it is going to be very wonderful. Then if you want to manage your time, then first and foremost point is keep you busy. You know why so many people are upset, why so many people are in tension? Because they are not busy. You know, busyness is very compulsory. If you are busy, then you will not think wrong. Can you imagine who thinks wrong, who thinks negative? Only those people who are free. Then you should never be free. If you are free, then you will think anything negative. That's why it is said that an empty mind is a house of devils. You know, so many people say an empty mind is a house of devils. That's why we should never be free, because freeness is a disease. If you want to prevent from freeness disease, then you should be busy, because busyness makes us perfect. So many people are getting perfect. Why? Because they are busy in somewhere. That's why we should keep ourselves busy. We should never keep ourselves free. So it is the first and foremost point to manage your time. You should be busy, but it should be a good work. You should not be busy in wrong work. You know, there are two types of work. First, from which we learn something, and the second, from which we waste something. Then we should be keep ourselves busy, but only in good works, not in bad works. What is the second point to manage your time? Improving yourself. Keep improving. If you want to manage your time, you should keep improving in your work. Then you can manage your time easily. Suppose I am a teacher. As you can see, I am an English teacher. Then I keep on improving my communication. At this time, what I am speaking, tomorrow I will try to speak better than today. It is called improving. We don't need to prove ourselves. We need to improve ourselves. When, as soon as we learn how to improve, then we can also manage our time. What is improvement? Improvement is this, whatever work you are doing, whatever profession you have, you should be best in that work. Like I'm teaching English at this time, I'm an English teacher, then I should be perfect. I should try to improve my teaching skill. You know, every day we should learn, we should improve each and every day. We should not waste our even a single day. When we learn how to improve every day, then we can manage time very easily. If you have free time, you don't have any work, then you can improve your own work. Suppose you are a businessman, then you should improve your business skills. At this time, whatever level you are, in whatever level you are, you should try to improve your level. It is called time management. Okay, so what is the second point? Keep improving. We should keep improving ourselves, whatever task we have in our life. And the third point is, don't waste your time. The most important point of time management is don't waste your time. Until or unless you waste your time, you can manage your time very easily. As soon as you do some work, you busy yourself, you keep busy yourself. That's why we should always do something and we should never waste our time. Because time and tide wait for none and past time never comes back. We should remember. Then you must be thinking, sir, mostly people waste their time, they don't have any work. If you are having free time, then you should keep on watching some good news. So I can understand many persons are in the habit of gossiping, many persons are in the habit of backbiting, many persons are in the habit of criticizing to others. In place of these things, you can improve your skills. How? By social media. You can watch good videos from which you can learn something. If you are having free time, you should watch some good videos from which you can learn something innovative. And if you want to learn English, then you should watch English podcasts, you should watch English channels, you should listen English. In this way, you can utilize your time, but don't waste your time. Another thing is that you can also read the books, because as we know, books are our best friend. And if we are having free time, then we should read the books. You can understand, either we can waste our time or we can use our time. Then which is the best option? We should use our time. Then there are many resources from which we can use our time. You can't say that we don't have anything. You have everything at this time. If you want to anything, you have social media, you have YouTube, you have Instagram. So all these social media platforms can provide you something good. If you want to find out something good, so it is not difficult now. You can find out everything good through social media. Because in social media also there are two aspects. First is wrong and second is right. So you should watch right things in social media. And as long as we are learning, we must be improving. Learning is compulsory. When we stop learning, we will stop improving. That's why we should keep on learning good habits. We should keep on learning good things from which we can improve ourselves. At this time, you know, the person who are skillful, the person who have some knowledge, the person who are really courageous and want to do something, they are respected. They are also given importance. You can see in your life there are two types of person. First are those who are ignored, and second are those who are respected. So what is the difference? Why people behave some people very rudely and why people behave some people very respectfully? What is the reason? Because the people who have knowledge, the people who have skill, they are very respected. Every person wants to talk to them. Every person wants to respect them. That's why we should become a skillful person. If you are a skillful guy, everybody will respect you. Everybody will give you honor. Now, what are these skills? Skills is like English communication. If you are having a skill of speaking English, so people will come to you for learning English. If you are having a skill of computer, so people will also respect you. They will come to you for learning computer. If you are having a skill of swimming, so people will come to you for learning swimming. Aren't they? Isn't it happening? It is happening at this time. What is necessary in present generation? What is requirement of people? People want skillful persons. Because in this scenario, so many people are not skillful. That's why we should be skillful. Whatever skill you have, if you have a skill of writing, then everybody will salute you. Everybody will appreciate you. If you are having a skill of reading, so people will appreciate you. If you are having a skill of explaining, if you are having a skill of convincing to others, so people will appreciate you. People will will admire you. So, present time, we should try to develop any good skill. If we are developing any good skill ourselves, then we will not go hunger. We will not go to under any person. If you have skill, so you don't need to do job anywhere. Skillful people can do their own work. Skillful people can start their own venture. That's why if you have skill, then you don't worry. You will survive very easily, because at this time skill is compulsory. Many people want to learn some skills. So if you are skillful, then you can teach skill to them. Can't you? So your skill always help you. So be skillful. That's it for today. Jai Hind.